guys for...
It was an adventure for sure. I mean, you're taking a piece of land that has never had really had food grown on it, and you're making it into, trying to make it into a viable farm.
I'm so grateful of Adam to invite me to McQuesten Urban Farm. This is actually the neighborhood that I grew up in.
My name is Adam Watson. I'm a project manager for the McQuesten Urban Farm. McQuesten Urban Farm is a project we have down here in the east end of Hamilton by the Red Hill Parkway that we started up back in 2012. We reclaimed a piece of unused city land in partnership with the McQuesten community to improve food access, to start farming and producing low-cost, healthy food in the neighborhood.
It's much more than a farm, which is what I learned today from Adam and from the community partners, is they've taken this small green space, which would have been idle green space, and converted it not only to a space that produces food for a neighborhood that requires some safe and affordable food, but it also offers programming, camps, educational programs for young children, as well as it leverages partnerships from corporate partners.
This is something I think that city staff should know more about and groups should engage with more. We've created this urban farm. It's unique in Canada. It's unique in North America. There's aspects of what we're doing here that when we have people coming from, you know, I've met people from Detroit and New York City and Toronto that have come. They're so impressed with what we're doing here. Hamilton is a leader in urban agriculture. We've now got 100 community gardens.
I remember growing up as a young person and having vegetable gardens. We grew up not only with a vegetable garden in the backyard, but we worked tender fruit as young people in our family. You always broke down fences around properties by, you know, extending a bag of vegetables or fruit over a fence to neighbors. And I think that's what this space provides.
We do well to produce food that meets the neighborhood's needs. We also produce food that we can sell outside the neighborhood to customers that can afford to pay more and help support the farm. I think that certainly would be one thing that we'd always look for, is those organizations and those city staff, people who are interested in supporting.
When you think of the vision, and when I mentioned the education programs, the best place to raise a child, and what's key to children is nutrition and food and providing education, and all that's provided through this space.
We run a low-cost kids camp where kids learn about food and farming.
This really was a great opportunity for me. I love being out. I love being in gardens. It's a pleasure. It's almost full circle for me to come back into the neighborhood that I grew up in, and seeing this facility and seeing what Adam and the broader team are accomplishing.
I think that's one of the main reasons I really wanted him to come out and see it, is to help be an ambassador for some of the great work we're doing down here.
I take a lot of pride in what Adam and others are doing, and I think it's a great example of work that staff are supporting that really improves the lives and quality of lives for the community.